welcome back to another Species Spotlight. I'm Miss Nicole here at the Tropical Forest and Botanical Garden in Key West. And today's Species Spotlight is going to be the Coontie plant. Here's an example of a Coontie. Now this species is native, also endemic, to Central and South Florida. So that means it's only gonna grow down in this end of Florida. They like the type of habitat that has salty, sandy soil and pineland hammock area, so that makes the botanical garden a perfect location for these plants to thrive and survive. They are a type of cycad, which actually means that they are toxic to humans. So technically all parts of this plant are toxic. Now you do see me touching it. They have a chemical called cysan, but if I go wash my hands, it'll be fine because it's water soluble. So if you remember back to our Species Spotlight about the sea poison, it's very similar in that aspect. But the part that's super dangerous with cycads is usually the seed pods, and that's very toxic, so you don't want to ingest that at all. Now something else with these plants is they have a unique, distinct look. They're almost feather-like in the way that the leaves grow, and they're very glossy. These plants are also very salt tolerant and drought tolerant. So that means that they can go long periods of time without any water or rain, which is perfect in the Keys. As you know, we have our wet and dry season. And then not to mention, with the salt tolerant, living in a coastal area, we have very like salty wind and rain. So it's good that they can handle that. And these leaves definitely give them that type of protection, the thick glossiness of them. Coonties are also known as dioecious, meaning they have male and female plants. So the one we're looking at here is a female. The way I know that is because these cone shapes that they have are very large. Now if we come take a look over here at this Coontie plant, just in comparison, this Coontie has very small cone shapes. So the males have the smaller cone shapes and the females have the larger cone shapes. Now we're going to head back to our female to look at the seed pod. So the cones are what holds the seeds. And here our female plant is getting ready to disperse the seeds. The seeds are a beautiful bright orange color. But once again, it is a cycad and they are very toxic to humans. So we don't want to touch them and definitely don't want to ingest them. Now with cycads, they have very interesting relationships in Earth. So they have a mutual beneficial relationship with another species. So the Coontie, for example, has a mutually beneficial relationship with two specific species of weevils. Now the weevils are only about a quarter of an inch long, so that's like very tiny. So they're not very big, it's not something we would see very obviously. What happens is that the weevils use the plant as food and shelter, so they're being protected by the Coontie. Now they're mutually beneficial because the weevils help spread the pollen, because as mentioned, they don't have flowers to spread the pollen. So the weevil will take the pollen from the male plant, which was over there, and they will carry the pollen to a female plant and then help it to produce and grow seeds. So that's today's Species Spotlight, the Coontie plant, and it's all about their uniqueness in our environments. They are endemic, so you will only find them here. So if you want to come check it out, come to the Key West Tropical Forest and Botanical Garden and see it for yourself. Join us next time for another Species Spotlight.